Here on The Vibe, we cover the most exciting trends of the world and the most inspiring culture stories of today, capturing hearts and minds. We begin today's program by entering into a space that's filled with a riot of vibrant colors. Pictures of dazzling flowers by photographer and filmmaker Mika Ninagawa, who's one of Japan's most acclaimed contemporary artists. As our reporter Lee Chong takes us on a tour, she realizes that while it displays romanticism and beauty, there's a somber side to it. From tender bud to full bloom and followed by the wilting of it, the artworks are also linked to life and death. It's a mix of emotions for Ninagawa, who wishes to share that soul-stirring journey with her fans. And after years of preparation, let's go check out her biggest exhibition ever here in Beijing.
Prismatic shots of flowers, intensive colors, and the psychedelic dimension created by camera. These all lead to the name Mika Ninagawa, a renowned Japanese female photographer.
全城石花是当代视觉艺术家里面呢不可忽视的存在，它的个人风格非常的鲜明。 他的镜头语言传递了一个非常强烈的艺术家个人的很多的情绪、情感，以及对人生和他对艺术的一些感悟，被他的很多的艺术粉丝称为“全川石花”的石花美学。他近十年的艺术创作的这个生命力都是非常旺盛的。The
name Mika Ninagawa is usually related to flowers and super saturated colors. As a result, this exhibition has drawn a lot of visitors, especially females, to take photos. I'm sure not a single lady of any age could say no to such a view.
I'm a photographer, and I mainly do 我非常喜欢摄影，我一直很喜欢它，就因为它的那个色彩非常的浓烈，也很奔放，很饱满嘛，就很有生命力。然后，所以我就特意穿了一个就是这个粉色的裙子，然后过来想说人跟这个展跟这整个的颜色整体有一个互动这样子。Being
a witness to Tokyo's modernity, Ninagawa also found her inspirations from the Japanese traditional sense of beauty, something some Chinese viewers are also familiar with.
因为我本身是插画师，所以跟他呢也算有一些的相关联。他的作品我能看到有点浮世绘的影子，就色彩极其的浓烈。The
Beijing exhibition has been the biggest solo one for Ninagawa ever since she received the Kimura Ihi Award, Japan's most prestigious photography award in 2001. This time, she created some pieces especially for Chinese fans. Offering splashes of color or light, the works are sometimes more profound than it appears at first glance. Actually, the blossoms we see in her works are not always expressing the bright moods as we might think. The works in this space are exhibited to the public for the first time. And are her reflections, her thoughts on the other side of life, just as how she tries to reveal in her films. Sakura, all kinds of flowers, fireworks, and goldfish are considered Ninagawa's symbolic codes. Other than that, her portraits have also gained attention. Particularly the photos of the Paralympic Games participants.
就跟别的摄影师拍的不同的是，他就除了表达那些选手的外形或者体貌特征以外，他还能看到这个选手的一个内心的世界。And
her self-portraits as well.
还有很多年轻人一看就会很有共鸣的艺术作品，包括他个人肖像的一些作品。
就是这些。对，我觉得全城石花是用他的镜头语言撰写他个人日志的。Journal as it is, Some of her personal experiences are revealed to her Chinese fans through exhibits.
这个展厅叫做《美丽的日子》，他拍摄他父亲从生病到去世一段时间的一系列作品。啊，他父亲最后的一段日子。对，他父亲其实也是日本非常知名的一个戏剧导演。对，所以其实对他的艺术生涯其实也是有非常大的影响。拍摄了很多在，比如说医院附近很有意向的作品。
这些都不是那么张扬了。对，整个空间其实和他其他系列作品有非常大的区别，
就是偏留白、偏安详、偏静谧的那种感觉。啊，这样说他那会儿怀孕了。对，他在他父亲重病的那段时间，他怀了他第二个孩子。嗯，他父亲是16年去世的，但是他其实也有讲过说他并没有觉得父亲的去世是一件非常让人悲伤的事情。 这个作品的最后一张作品其实是以他和他孩子的影子作为结束，他自己也作为了一个生命的一个连接，跟他父亲告别之后也有新的生命诞生，一种生命的延续感。对，
哇，这个厅的颜色就特别浓烈了，就你刚才那完全不一样了。
对，
这个是在很美好的心情下创作的吗？
其实也算是，我们现在看到了非常多的颜色，不同颜色的花组合在一起，其实不是一种自然界一个景观，对，它其实是人造花或者是有人工着色的痕迹在。 然后我们这一系列作品，它其实叫《Imaginary Garden》，然后它其实是在墓地去拍摄的，去祭祀啊，去扫墓，我们都会去欣赏我们的鲜花嘛。这里面有很多的假花存在，所以全川就去拍摄了这一系列的作品。因为人造花，它和真实的花，最大的区别在于就是它没有凋谢，它没有生与死。
那我们看来这个太美好了，就是自然界，然后它可能在想的。
跟死亡有关。对，这也是全川其实他创作背后非常大的一个影响，就是在日本的传统审美下，其实有一种叫物哀思想嘛，就是表达当时他们时代背景下或者对生死的一种思考，所有东西会逝去的，然后对生死是能够接受的一种态度。Then
what does photography mean to Ninagawa? The artist says that's part of being alive. And a good portion of that. Li Qiong, CGTN, Beijing.